Problem 16. 110 sixth semester students were interviewed, and this was found. The total of students were 110. 28 students took business, 31 took nutrition, 42 took philosophy, 9 took both business and nutrition, 10 took both business and philosophy, and 6 took both nutrition and philosophy. And only 4 students took all 3 courses. So now we have to build a Venn diagram.
The first thing we're going to do is place the numbers that are given on the instructions inside the Venn diagram. First, we're going to place the number 4 of students they all have in common. Then, to find the students that study both business and nutrition, you need to subtract 9, that is the number of students that study both, minus the 4 that study 3 courses. Then, we're going to repeat this process with the next 2 numbers that are missing. Business and philosophy is 10 minus 4 equals 6 students. Nutrition and philosophy, 6 minus 4 equals 2 students. Now to find the numbers that are missing, you have to subtract the total of students of each class with the number of students in the inner circles. Let's start with business. You have to subtract the total of students who study business with the 5, 4, and 6. This gives you 13. Then, for nutrition, you subtract 31, minus 5, minus 4, and minus 2. And this gives you 20 students. Last but not least, for philosophy, you subtract 42, minus 4, minus 6, and minus 2. And this gives you 30 students. To find the numbers of students that don't take any classes, you need to add all the numbers that are inside the Venn diagram. And this total, that is 80. You subtract it with the total of students, that is 110. The number of students that do nothing are 30 students.
If we randomly choose a 6th semester student, what is the probability that student A took none of the 3 subjects? So what they're asking you for is for all the students who took none of these 3 classes. So you look for the 30 who studied nothing and do 30 divided by 110, which is all the amount of students, and that will give you 27%. B took business yet not nutrition nor philosophy. So as you can see in this question, they want only the ones who took business. So as you can see in the diagram, there's 13. So you do 13 divided by 110, which will give you 11.8%. C took philosophy and business, yet not nutrition. So in this question, you can see they're asking you for the ones who study philosophy and business, but not nutrition. So as you can see in the diagram, there's a 6. So you use a 6 and you divide it by 110, and that will give you 5.4%. D took business or nutrition. So in this problem, we're going to be using the formula for the probability business or nutrition. So it'll be the probability of A plus the probability of B minus the probability of A and B, being that A is business and B is nutrition. So we substitute the numbers and we will have 13 over 110 plus 20 over 110 minus 5 over 110. And we will be 14 over 55, which give you 25%. We built too many false alarms. We're going E took at least one of the three subjects. So now we're looking for at least having one class. So we'll do the probability of X being equal or greater to 1, which we will have to take the amount of students that take only one class. So it'll be 30 plus 20 plus 13, which will give you 73, and we will divide it by 110, which gives you 72.7%. F took at least two of the three subjects. So now we're going to do the same but with the two classes, so we can see it's 6, 2, and 5. And 4, because it says at least. So when you add them up, it's equals to 17, which you do 17 divided by 110, which will give you 15.4%. G took at least two courses. So now we're trying to know the ones who do only exactly two classes. So we do 6 plus 5 plus 2, which give you 13 over 110, which give you 11.8%. H took exactly one course. So now we want exactly one class. So we will do 30 plus 20 plus 13, which gives you 63 over 110, which gives you 57.2%. Number 20, find the family of antiderivative 4.
First of all, you need to expand the problem. You need to, the 6x cubed will become to 36x6, and then the square root that you have will you need to take to change it and convert it into a fraction so that it is easier to work with. After that, you need to do the method of adding 1 to the exponent and then divide it by that same number, and you will have a more simplified problem. The only problem that you have is that the fraction that you already have, the 7 over 2, will become a tortilla method because you have two fractions combined. And after that, you need to do the next step.
Now we need to do the tortilla method. We multiply 2 times 7, and that goes on the bottom, and 7 times 4, and it goes in the numerator. And that gives us 2x to the power of 7 fourths minus 3x over 4 to the fourth power.